you see that he's a scruffy ranger. He spent the past 80 years out sleeping in the woods, in the mud, in the rain, and has a sort of crown that doesn't seem like he wears it well on his head. He's just like a sort of rugged, outdoorsy guy. And he looks, is dropped onto that platform, looks down at you, Efink, and goes,
"Oh, sweetheart, I am, they made me king. I'm the king of Tyrius."
Yes. Serve him, serve him, Efink, now's your chance.
Do I serve him? Do I become queen? Do I serve him? Do
hey,
I become
queen? Don't worry, gal, I'm a rescue. Oh, yeah, they say I gotta live in a big stone house.
Yeah. Look, it was one night. It was a mistake. Now I'm seeing the benefits. Oh, you love me.
I love you.
Oh, you love me.
Yeah. You're the prettiest self I've ever seen.
Well, that's true.
Okay.
I'm so conflicted right now.
Speaking of the High King of Tyriath, he is going to rush over here. And you see he goes,
Corsair, dang it, you gotta stop. Hey, I'm the King of Tyriath.
Okay, buddy, I will.
I lived in the woods for 80 years as a ranger, and I know how to make a lean-to.
Yeah, I made a good job sticking to the sea.
You see, he's going to take some swings at you.
Oh.
Here we go.
Wow.
Bum.
It was a phase. It was a phase.
He deals 54 points of damage to you as he takes, he goes,
my dad-in-law made this sword. It was berkin, but now it's working again.
It was berkin?
Yeah, I get you.
And he just lashes out this crazy primal swing, scores you for 54 points of damage. He looks like, he's like a grimy, he fight like a dirty fighting kind of dude. He looks at you, Efink, and you see he goes,
"Listen, I know you don't like to live on dirt, but you could live with me in the big house in Kellentor. We could be happy there."
That sounds lovely, but foreboding.
No, the only thing that's foreboding is my heart.
Your what? One more time.
My heart. Come on, be my girl, be my wife.
And he is flung through the air and is about to hit the lava, gets snapped by one of these yellow tentacles and sucked into the maw of the lava log.
No.
You can feel Stalker in the gullet of the lava mug, kind of going like, "Good ding, ding, dang, freaking lava bear.
You heard her."
He goes, yeah, gets out of there and starts to leap out of the maw and goes,
"I darn love you so much. Please be my partner."
Wait, you don't love me, Simon?
I dang love you.
Oh, you dang love me. Yes, I haven't made up my mind, but I've seen the way you fight, and it is compelling. I might not join your group, but you might have to join mine.
Okay, do I have to live in a stone house?
You have to. I will not make you live.
All right.
Can I try to get him to role play with me so it seems like some natural form of him joining the team?
Make an insight check.
Okay.
Ooh.
9.
Yeah, you can get him to role play with you. You can try to get him to role play.
Okay. Now, Stalker, about this business of us divorcing.
You don't want to be my wife?
Well, remember all of the divorce papers I've sent you.
Uh-huh.
Well, okay. So now you're going to sign them because I hate you.
Which part is the lie?
Wait.
Is there a lie?
No, there's not. There's no lie. Sign the papers and we'll divorce right now.
I don't know how to write my name down.
Okay, right. Okay, what do you want, king of men and elves and dwarves?
Okay, you stabbed up the little girl real good, so I thought I'd put some, you can make a poultice out of, you know, there's plants, you got herbs, and there's secret elf medicine.
Wait, are you suggesting that you join our team?
Yep.
Okay. Well, it looks like we have a new team member, and he and I are king.
I'm gonna pump the brakes on us. This guy who just stabbed me 3 times.
You hear. And all you get that cold shiver down your spine. And you see that Stalker looks up and goes, they got glass in their throat.
They got glass in their throat.
Sound like cracking on a plate.
Make my ears hurt.
Always sounds like he just had a whiskey or something. You know?
Do so much better.
I know.
You can eat your boogers.
I lean over and plant a weird kiss. It's so funny.
If you need to for food, because they can, it's, you know, every bit counts in a survival scenario.
Yeah.
All right. Well,
off topic. Trash.
You got trash in your ear? Because you can use trash to make a blanket.
I do want to ask Percival. You say you can build a mean lean-to.
Uh-huh.
You ever build a hat?
Build a hat?
Yeah, that phrase is a little weird.
Forge a crown.
Have you ever beat anything into submission so hard that it became something
else?
I don't know
if I fully trust.
Yes, the man can barely feed himself. I'm not entirely certain.
Hey, I can feed myself. I know that's how I know to do that.
He also tried to kill us not 15 minutes ago.
Answer the question, just please.
What do they, I can make a lean-to, and I know how to make a platform in a tree, because you can sleep in a tree if you're going deer hunting.
Okay.
Right.
Where's this going? Right. I don't know. Why don't you go and have a snack, baby?
I hate you so much.
Hey, you got more legs than normal for a lady.
Okay, you need to go. Please don't talk to anyone. He's
problematic for sure.
You see that Stalker goes, the woods are just a place where you can go out and be by yourself. You don't have to think about how you're descended from a famous king or empress. And then you can see a bird.
All right.
Why don't you go play with Uncle Stalker?
And a bunch of legs immediately swarm.
Spiders swarm all over them. That's not
I do find myself married to the king of men, elves, and dwarves.
Stalker looks over at you and he goes.
Yeah, Lilith looks over at Stalker.
He looks over and says, there's some places in the rock around here you could put a snare and catch a ribbon.
So, right. And though he is grotesque, he does, just having him on our side, doesn't it, I don't know, like, feel really good?
Do you love him?
You know, if you got cold, you could take your hair off your head and make a blanket. In a survival scenario, if you were in a survival scenario, you make a blanket.
Do you love me? Hey, over there.
Uh-huh.
Percival, do you love me?
Yeah.
I love that he loves me.
You're the prettiest girl I ever saw.
Oh.
Not a lot of loving statements. Relationships start with, hey, you over there.
So you see Stalker runs after you and he goes, oh, and Galfast, get out of here.
Stalker.
Yeah.
Sweetie, did you unchain Halfling?
No, I put the elvish medicine on her because we were taking a nap. So she woke up.
Who stopped me from killing him?
No, you guys tried to kill her, but I brought her back with elf medicine.
No, I meant killing you. I'm talking about specifically killing you.
Yeah, no, don't kill him. Just don't kill him. Not just yet. He's
a
king.
If you married and I killed you, you'd still be queen.
No one would recognize it.
No, we need him.
This is a fella I stabbed 3 times and then he was too scared, so he jumped on a bird.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Hey, we have
don't
a bigger pressing problem.
No, and you're not gonna downplay the cool ass shit that I did.
You wear a lot of jewels like a fancy, you're fancy man.
Yeah, I'm real fancy. Real fancy.
You.
Percival, you're pissing people off right now. You should probably shut your mouth.
You. Are a nature man. That is one of the few things that you can do. Is that not the case? And you tracked these halflings halfway across the lands, did you not?
It's hard to call me stalker. I'm good at I can find you.
Yes, no, because I love you and because you love me, you will find this halfling.
All right, let's do it.
Her stupid husband also brought me here. I'm gonna do a perception check.
Cool, go for it.
Oh no, Percival.
25.
Percival looks at you, and he goes,
yeah, well, I was trekking Hamhead, and she must have come by through here, but then when we saw all them coming through, we kind of dipped off the trail to come here and talk to your friends. I can jump back on the trail.
Wouldn't you stay on the trail? And we said find the halfling.
I thought maybe you knew about a web.
I'm sorry, what?
I thought maybe you knew about a web.
Knew about a web? You're going to have to be-
Oh my God.
Did I distract you, honey?
Yeah, you're the prettiest lady in the world.
Yeah, that's on repeat, isn't it?
Yeah, we could go live in the forest.
Oh my God, you're starting to repeat a lot of things. A soundboard?
Well, I got chewed up pretty bad in that lava monster.
Enough!
I've literally said it the entire time that I wanted to keep the good guy around.
Plenty of fish in the stream. You guys want to come over for dinner, you're welcome.
Stalker looks down. As he goes rush towards the ship, he looks down and goes, and pulls a thread from the little spine of stone the statue,
and he goes, oh, look at that. That's a halfling cloak.
And rushes off towards the ship.
I have a wonderful gesture to make. I look at Percival and I say, Percival, kiss me.
Oh, heck yeah.
And I push him off the balcony.
Again!
So we good?
Dang it, dang!
It's
falling a long way.
It's very high tower.
800
stories.
Swap!
Okay, great. Are we good?
We were good, but like I felt like he could have helped us find this halfling. But let's get in the ship.